Welcome in this week Technical Tuesday with NXGAM. Today I will show how to define machine devices and add them to library. I will use tool holders which we mount on a turret as an example. But first let's see how can we use devices which are already existing in out-of-the-box NXGAM. When you have your machine tool simulation kit loaded, you should see special pocket objects which might be used as placeholders for tools or devices. We can see device library right under tool library. Devices can be classified as track, tool holder and head. Today I'm using tool holders. And here is the list of available holders. I will pick one and you will see that it automatically jumps into its place. I will load one more holder. Notice how we can move them between stations of a turret. Let's create our own device. I will start by creating new empty file and importing Parasolid with my holder geometry. Here you can see where devices directory is in NX. In graphics folder, I will create subfolder for my device and save it here. Next, I will create a component which will contain this geometry. This way, in main file, I will have only kinematics of the device defined, and this geometry will be in a child component. Now it's time to define kinematics of the device. We do this in Machine Tool Builder application, in Machine Tool Navigator tab. Components can be created by right-clicking on root object in this tab, and choosing Insert Machine Component. Geometry of the device should be selected here. My best practice is to select always entire component, not bodies, in case if this component would be modified later. This component should be classified as device. Also, we should specify a coordinate system, which will be a junction between the holder and the turret. It is located in this point, obviously, but to be sure how it should be oriented, we have to know how the corresponding junction on a turret are oriented. You can check it in your machine tool kinematics definition. We can see that x-axis is pointing down and y-axis to the right. And we will use the same orientation in our holder. This junction must be classified as tool mount. we should add one more component as a child to previous one. It should be classified as static holder. I will also remove holder ID, so it will inherit the number from number of station of a turret. Here we will create one more junction. It will be junction between cutting tool and the holder. Also, orientation of this coordinate system is important. I will save and close file with our new device, geometry and kinematics. Next step is to add a new entry in devices library for our new holder. We do this in device database.file, which you can find in ASCII folder. This file can be opened with Notepad. In its header you will find description of each parameter, which makes it very easy to understand how to read it. To add my holder, I will simply copy one of existing entries, replace its name with name of my device, and add a description. To make sure that modifications of CAM libraries will be visible in NX, we can reload configuration files. As you can see, our new holder is on the list. The description which we added before is also visible here. And our new holder looks correct. Now I will show you how do we add lathe tools in this kind of holders in NXCAM. I will choose right hand holder. As you can see, we need to orient the tool correctly. First, I will change holder angle. I would like to use P2 for tool oriented like this. And here you can see that tool tracking point is positioned exactly in tool mount junction of the holder. I will now adjust size of the holder and add offset values to pull out tool from its holder. Here you can see how we can use X-mount and Y-mount values to position lathe tool. And let's also add an operation to this tool and see that everything works in simulation. Now I will show you how to modify this tool from right hand to left hand. As you saw, all we need to do is to change two parameters, holder hand and insert position. I will show you one more example of defining a device. It will be holder for a drilling or milling tool. Steps are almost identical like in previous case. Here I would like to mention one more best practice. When you define a coordinate system, using dynamic positioning, there is no relation between geometry. To achieve coordinate system which will stay associative to the geometry, we can use, for example, XY origin positioning method. This way, if you will modify geometry of the holder, positions of junctions will be adjusted automatically.
Thank you for watching. See you in next Technical Tuesday with NCmatic.